Thank you. It's great to be here. I'm getting over a cold, so excuse me if I have to cough halfway through. I live in West Yorkshire, but I've lived in London on and off for many years. And my first poem is inspired by that well-known London weekday ritual, the tube ride to work. And perhaps it goes some way to explain why I decided to leave the capital. It's called The Mind Gap. A woman in a striped acrylic blouse perfume bombs me as the packed train to Paddington seals out St. John's Wood. She uncrumples a frown, straightens her newspaper, then props it carefully against the bridge of my nose. I think this lady may be attempting to dislodge my glasses. I complain cheerily to the man beside me. His face slides shut. Contorting to escape the stink of ink, I become wrapped by a tube ad that rattles on about cut-rate laser eye surgery. The woman positions the skewer of the red cork tube on top of my left unlaced groove, applies pressure. "Excuse me," I object into my iPhone. "I believe you're standing on my foot." "I'm so sorry," she responds in Helvetica. Then persists, "I was just reading about you. It's such a tragedy, your condition." She lowers her mask. The train is wharfed by the dank mouth of a tunnel. I can only see her pumpkin grin, firefly eyes. I feel her heel pin me to the floor like a shadow. I make a stab at a scream, but all that escapes is an apology. When I was living in London, I'd often go walking in the South Downs, usually along the chalk cliffs of the Seven Sisters. And the poem I'm about to read you came out of one of those walks that I went on a few years ago with a friend. It's called Walking on Cliffs. Remember when you found that horseshoe by the kissing gate, zipped it in your backpack for luck. Your new high-tech walking trousers ripped on gauze at the cliff's edge, but you thought the draft was down to their patented air vent system. Your knickers were on show all the way to Eastbourne. In the pub, we laughed till the sun left the room. Then your glass smashed. "Did you hear a couple jump this morning?" the barman asked as he swept aside the splinters. They'd lost their son to leukemia. Was it them we saw with the birthday balloon? Did they drop the orange peel I kicked into the scrub? Was it them who lay down at Grass Point, leaving their outlines printed on the summer grass? Next, a poem inspired by a wish many people have, particularly poets, I imagine, to get away from it all and indulge in some solitary time. It imagines a haven on the Isle of Skye, but the location, to me at least, it could be anywhere remote and near water. It's called Skye and Sea. A mist-washed boffy on the Isle of Skye, where kestrels thread cloud to purple heather. Breakfast is salted oats, a red kipper, sweet tea. There's just the one room, one chair, one spoon. A snowed-in boffy on the Isle of Skye, where ice slides a tongue under the door. Ghost breath lingers like wood smoke. Nights uncoil into Nostalati shadows. A sun-trawled boffy on the Isle of Skye, with crow's nest views of otters on the lock. Sheets draped, drying on a rowan tree. Wasps feeding kisses from the lip of a jar. A whitewashed boffy, a kaleidoscope sky, where weather colours sea, mountain, mind, where the sole interference is a rush of tide over sand. Tide over sand. Tide over sand. And this is a fairly new poem set quite near where I live in West Yorkshire. It's called The Swan Man of Minerwood. November, just past blown out time. A man walks towards me on the Rochdale Canal towpath, cradling a bone-white electric guitar. Left hand cupping its slender neck. As he floats into focus, his guitar transmutes into a swan. The bird's flattened girth suggests death by traffic. It wears the straitjackets of rigor mortis. The man's demeanour is that of country squire out for some evening air. His clothes are rough sleeper ragged. His hair is oiled rope. Swerving from his trajectory, I trip too close to the waterway's black slick. Ponder why he's carrying a lifeless swan. But don't we all suffer burdens that defy logic? Homunculi, with their DNA stitched childhood or the stars. As we pass, the man croons hello in the style of Lionel Richie, and a brace of rubbery feet flutters against my hand. I walk on a little, stop, then drop to my knees to dip the tainted hand in liquid light. The moon's reflection scatters like stickleback. I came out as a gay teenager way back in 1983, here in Manchester, actually. And back then, AIDS was only just beginning to have an impact here in Britain. And initially, from my memory, it was the gay men who'd been out on the scene since the 1970s who were worst affected. Many of these men lost their lives. To me, they're heroes because in a way they were out and proud in a time of open hostility towards the LGBT community. And in my view, they made partying, dancing to the likes of Sylvester and Donna Summer, a form of civil rights activism. So my next and my final poem is dedicated to them. And just so that you know, it ends on a list of nightclubs, gay nightclubs. And these were pioneering in the way that they opened very early on in the gay social movement in the 1970s and early 80s. And some of these clubs I went to in Manchester. And the early ones, of course, I didn't go to because they were in the 1970s and they were in London. But that happens at the end of the poem. Return of the discotheque dancers. Come back, you glistening boys, you clerks and scholars, farmhands, plumbers, you makeup artists, money men, you lives packed short, you oh so very dazzling, you boho fops, you preachers, poachers, lovers, sons, my sons. Years ago we buried you in shame, you bore the guilt as night closed in. So many men, so little time, the chorus rang. When the dry ice lifted and the spotlight glowered, so many friends were gone. Rise up, break free of soil, of stone, of ivy's snare. Come chase the hare, the handsome fox. Rattle cages, shake your bones. Come back for one last wicked whirligig. Imbibe the city, its bars and clubs, its tribes and scars. Refrains that moved us then will tug the moon. Shed your shirts, your wounded skin, shatter the glass dance floor. ourselves half sung. So flex your voices, roar like guns. Tallulah's waiting. Devilish nuns are roller skating. Come back, you glistening boys. Let's march again at heroes, high society, Napoleons, the catacombs, bang, and heaven, heaven.